Okay, all this is bullshit. Excuse me. Before I just begin this video, make sure you guys run over there, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and make sure you guys subscribe to my boy Millaboy Gaming for more gaming and live streaming and so forth. Man, this episode of The Flash was freaking lit. This damn episode of The Flash was so damn lit, man. Let me tell you how. The very first opening scene of The Flash, we see Nora in the time vault once again, pretty much just sending a message to Eva Thorn, telling her, pretty much giving her like a mementoist kind of message about how much he's mentored her about the timeline and shit like that. And for the most part, it was so cool because, you know, she's starting to realize just how much damage she's actually dealing to the team and the parents, most importantly, because she's lying to them. And we learn at the very end of the episode, she said she'll do anything she can to protect the family that she loves and wants to preserve because she loves them that much. That includes lying if she has to. You know, because my boy Sherloque is not on that bullshit that Rookie is treating everybody else. He knows that she's up to something. In fact, towards the very end of the episode, he asked her, like, okay, so what was your defense mechanism anyway? He asked Nora that, and she almost fucking confessed, but she's like, you know what? You know, Chuck was like, it was your memories about how you felt about your mother. Which we all find out to be a lie, because while we were in the flashback, we were in the various fanboying about how much he's loved and respected by Central City, her defense mechanism was the Flash, and how they got out was so cool, because how they got out were these portals, these neural pathways and portals were hidden in plain sight. Like, for example, with Grace's, how Nora got out of hers was, it was that dollhouse that Nora's pointing out earlier in the episode. She's like, you know, that's very, very unique. I like that. So these are, you know, in the same way with Barry, Iris had to realize that the lie that Nora told her about, you know, in terms of Iris being as nasty as my mother was just a lie. It was a defense mechanism because she was always so angry, which is why Sherloque and Caitlin, you know, they realized, like, you know, the reason why the portals were hidden is because anything that's negative, like anger and sadness, those block those neural pathway portals, you know, and that was actually pretty cool. I liked how they did that. We also learned how much of a loving mother Iris actually is. You know, at first we saw Nora just being a loner, you know, a kid by herself in the fashion room, while other kids, you know, played and just relished in the memorabilia of the Flash, whereas Nora had this one sneaky little toy. And at first, when this is back when we saw, you know, the last still present, you know, with Iris storming in there being angry at Nora because she couldn't find it. So Nora said, you know, as a little girl, she was just like, this isn't fair because I want to know my father. Everyone else seems to know him, but I don't know him. You know, this isn't fair. You know, she was crying, you know, and Iris was there to conform her and confide in her and comfort her. And it was so nice to see that because, you know, the same thing happened with the race, actually. This is really interesting too. When they first go into Grace's consciousness, actually using the same thing using the little mechanism from Sherloque's Earth, F-21, they end up in CCPD's police station, you know, and that's where we see Grace. That was her very first memory, is going there, I guess, you know, and Nora finds her there, you know, so she's trying to figure out, okay, how the hell, you know, I get out of here now. So when Nora was trying to get in there, she went in there by herself, mind you. While the team was out, you know, when the Starlights were shut down, it was dark, you know, which was definitely jumped the gun, which is very much against what Sherloque advised, which is to go with the partner, because in a very funny yet serious way, you know, Sherloque was like, I caught my friend Watson, you know, banging my fourth wife, you know, doing that in that very memory. So and he ended up dying in brain there because he was trapped there. So the same thing happened with Nora. She got trapped there because she waited too damn long. And because of Grace's brain, you know, thought that Nora was a pathogen, which is a bad bacteria for the body. So her brain pretty much closed the portal because, you know, they thought Nora was bad, so that's what happened. So the same thing happened with Barry and Iris when they were in the Flash Museum, except they were caught in Nora's memories, which I think really did a lot of good insight into Nora and how she became who she became and as a kid, because Barry didn't want to intervene. It's not like he could have because it was a fixed memory, as he later found out. Because Barry said, you know, I might never get to see my daughter like this as of being a little kid. So this is back when they were still caught in the lie perception, so to speak. So it was cool for Barry to see that. You know, he was also, like I said, fanboying with the fact that the Flash Museum really immortalized him like this. It was very actually cool because then there was even a Hall of Villains, you know. Then we see Iris save her man's life from the husk of the Reverse Flash using the Thinker's chair beam. Yeah, that was actually pretty cool in itself. I really like that. And let's get on to the big part with you. We finally get to see and know that Grace has actually been able to listen to everything that Cicada's been telling her, the doctor. So that creates, you know, in its own little right, Grace is actually the big bad of this season, if that makes any sense, because she's pretty much a host of that same animosity that her Uncle Orvin has towards metahumans. I'm in a coma right now because of metahumans, that damn satellite. So she ends up fighting Nora with her brain, you know, because her race's defense, biggest defense mechanism is her Uncle Orvin, who we actually get to see when he's a lot older. But now, here's the thing. I don't know if Uncle Orvin, I don't know if that was Cicada as race's biggest defense mechanism or not, because, you know, remember something, in that area where they're at the back of their house, that's how Grace wishes that their house was. You know, pancake ceremony, Orlin being happy. You know, it took some time for him to be happy, become a happy family and things of that nature, but she never really knew that. So, but that's my initial point. I'm not sure if that was actually Cicada with that dagger or not. I thought it was like an older version of Grace when she gets older or something. Because of that long-ass blonde hair, you know, from what it looked like, you know. So, also, you know, my boy Cisco has a girl now, Camila. He meets at the Loud Kitty, the bar that Ralph goes to. We learn a lot about Ralph, too. He looks like he's ready to settle down, and I actually have a video ready for that, too. I'll be dropping that tomorrow. My boy Ralph finally be having his little love connection finally here with Cisco. Cisco also finds it and actually completes the metahuman cure. And when Barry gets that message, he's like, okay, I'm going to use that on Cicada. And then also, you know, Iris is ready to start her own little newspaper thing. So, and she was a little nervous about that because Gloria told her the only one that's open is the Century City Citizen, you know, which is the very name of the paper that, in which Iris writes the article of the Flash disappearing, which creates all this travesty in her personal life because Barry's gone. You know, that's something she really wanted to avoid, which is why she didn't tell Barry about it, which is why she opted to go into Nora's brain to get her, because she didn't want to tell Barry about that. But now, after talking to Barry, like, really, look, like I told you before, that's not going to be you. You're not going to be that angry mother. I know in any future, past or present, you're going to be a great mother. And it's time for you to believe that. I believe that you'll be, as you believe that, that's exactly what's going to happen, and looks like now it is. But like I said, I love how my boy Sherloque is closing in on Nora. Like, he's got his sweating bullets. So, this episode was pretty damn cool. I really enjoyed that. And we'll see what happens next time, man.